Introduction to the Boundary and Annexation Survey, or BAS 2, How to Participate. This video will introduce the BAS Annual Response Email, explain the importance of reviewing the U.S. Census Bureau's boundary data before determining whether there are boundary changes to report to BAS, introduce the Annual Response Form, and list the available response methods participants can use to complete and return their boundary updates. This video will also include demonstrations showing how to review existing boundary data and how to complete the annual response form. Every year in early January, the Census Bureau sends the annual response email to all eligible tribal, state, and local governments. This email notifies governments of the upcoming BAS cycle and provides instructions on how to participate. The link shown in the slide is included in the BAS email and directs participants to the How to Get Started page of the BAS website. On the How to Get Started page, there is a section titled How to Participate, which provides participants with step-by-step instructions for reviewing the Census Bureau's boundary data, completing the annual response form, and submitting boundary updates to BAS. BAS participants are strongly encouraged to review the Census Bureau's current boundary data for their government before completing the annual response form. This is the first step to participating in BAS. This is an example that highlights the importance of reviewing the Census Bureau's current boundary data prior to completing the annual response form. On the map, the blue line represents the boundary that the Census Bureau had on file for this government as of the 2015 BAS. In 2016 and 2017, the government annexed a significant amount of land, but did not respond to the 2016 or to the 2017 BAS. As a result, these annexations were not added to the Census Bureau's database, and the boundary data on file remained unchanged. In 2018, the new BAS contact did not review the current boundary data the Census Bureau had on file prior to completing the annual response form. Since there were no annexations on file within the government's records for that year, they reported no changes. Because the government did not review the current boundary data on file before reporting no changes to the 2018 BAS, the areas shaded in red were not included in the Census Bureau's representation of the government's boundary. This affects the government's housing and population count and affects the allocation of federal funding to this community. Participants have multiple options available to review their boundaries. TigerWeb is a web-based mapping application that allows users to visualize the Census Bureau's topologically integrated geographic encoding and referencing, or TIGER system, and provides a simple way to view TIGER data without downloading any data. Participants also have the option to download partnership shapefiles for use within their own geographic information systems or GIS software, download BAS PDF reference maps, or use the Geographic Update Partnership software, referred to as GUPS, to review their boundaries. All of these tools are available on the BAS website. To get started reviewing boundary data, navigate to the BAS website and click How to Get Started. Then, scroll to Step 1A of the How to Participate section. Here, participants will find the four options they can use to review their boundaries. Participants who wish to use the TigerWeb online map viewer should select TigerWeb. In the TigerWeb applications panel on the left side of the screen, select the first option for TigerWeb. When opening the web page, users should see a map in the center of the screen and a menu on the left-hand side. Before beginning their review, users will need to select a data vintage to view from the dropdown. On the left side of the screen, select Current from the Select Vintage dropdown menu and turn on the appropriate boundary layer for the government, making sure to select the Labels tab if not already selected. Click the empty box next to the layer name of the government type to view the boundary. Layers containing legal boundaries include American Indian, Alaska Native, and Native Hawaiian areas, places and county subdivisions, and states and counties. There should now be a check mark in the box. These layers include the legal boundaries as reported through the previous year's BAS. Next, select the icon depicting a globe and magnifying glass in the upper right corner to open the query tool, then select the Attribute tab. Under the Select Map option, choose American Indian, Alaska Native, and Native Hawaiian areas, places and county subdivisions, or states and counties. Under the Select Layers option, participants should choose either the type of government they represent or the boundary to review. Enter the name of the government in the Enter Name a Feature box, then click Submit. Go to the Task Results tab in the upper left corner of the page and view the query results. Select the name of the government to zoom to the boundary. Zoom and pan around the boundary to review by left-clicking and moving the mouse. Users can change the map background to show terrain, landmass, or satellite imagery by clicking the background icon in the upper right corner of the map. Participants who prefer not to use TigerWeb may choose from a few other tools to review their boundaries. The Census Bureau provides bundled partnership shapefiles for experienced GIS users who prefer to review their boundaries within their own GIS software. Participants who opt for this method will use the Census Bureau's File Transfer Protocol, or FTP, site to download the shapefiles. To view the partnership shapefiles, select Partnership Shapefiles. This webpage is updated every year prior to the beginning of BAS in early January. For example, for the 2021 BAS, the Census Bureau will provide 2021 BAS Partnership Shapefiles. From the Choose a State to View drop-down menu, select the appropriate state. On the next screen, select up to 5 counties or county equivalents and click Submit. The zip files containing the county or county equivalents partnership shapefiles will begin to download. Depending on the size of the entity and the number of counties selected, this data may take a few minutes to download. Click the Save As button to save the zip files to a local drive on the computer, then unzip the files to the same folder. There are two zip files within this folder. One file ends with the state FIPS code and contains the partnership shapefiles at the state level, and the other file ends with the county FIPS code and contains the partnership shapefiles within the selected county. The Census Bureau recommends participants use the file containing the county shapefiles. Once the appropriate file or files have been unzipped, they are ready to use within a GIS software. These partnership shapefiles show all the legal boundary data the Census Bureau has on file as reported through the previous year's BAS. During the boundary review, the participant should primarily use the county, edges, MCD, and place layers, though other layers are available for reference as well. The county layer will show the county or county equivalent boundary. The edges layer contains all the linear features for the county or county equivalent, including roads, waterways, and railroads. The MCD and place layers show the boundaries for all minor civil divisions, or MCDs, and incorporated places, respectively. Participants should use the partnership shapefiles in conjunction with their own current boundary data to identify any discrepancies. Participants who are not experienced GIS users and who prefer not to use TigerWeb have the option to use the Census Bureau's BAS PDF maps to review their boundaries. To access the BAS maps, select BAS Maps from the How to Participate section. Updates to this webpage occur every year prior to the beginning of BAS in early January. For the 2021 BAS, the Census Bureau will provide 2021 BAS Maps. The BAS Maps are the most recent maps created for the BAS program and display the updated legal boundaries and names as reported through the previous year's BAS. These reference maps are created for counties or county equivalents, MCDs, incorporated places, consolidated cities, American Indian areas, Alaska Native areas, and Hawaiian homelands. Scroll to the correct entity type and select the appropriate state from the drop-down menu. Then, select the appropriate entity ID or government name. This PDF file contains the bundled large format map sheets that participants can use to review their existing boundary data. Upon opening this file, participants will see a map border containing the title of the map and entity name, as well as basic map elements, such as a legend, north arrow, and scale. In the bottom right corner is information about the entity name, entity type, and state. Participants can also find information about the specific map sheets from this area of the map. There are three types of map sheets included in the PDF map file depending on the size of the entity. Index map sheets, shown here, cover the entire extent of the entity and contain numbered grids that correspond to parent map sheets. Only larger entities with more than one parent map sheet will have an index map sheet. Parent map sheets, shown here, provide a detailed view of a section of the entity and correspond to the numbered grid on the index map sheet. Parent map sheets are useful for identifying boundary data within an entity. Inset map sheets show details for congested areas on parent map sheets. If a parent map sheet has an associated inset map sheet, there will be a shaded area with a letter and number combination, for example, A1. The data frame contains a map of the entity showing boundary information. Participants using these maps as a reference should use the boundary symbology and geographic features on the map to identify areas where boundary data is not correct. For information on reviewing boundaries using GUPS, refer to the Geographic Update Partnership Software, or GUPS, video series. After participants review the Census Bureau's existing boundary data, the second step to participating in BAS is to complete the annual response form. Participants may access the annual response form from the BAS website. Participants will use this form to indicate if there are any legal boundary changes to report to that year's BAS and indicate their preferred participation method for reporting changes, review their government's tribal chair, or TC, or highest elected official, or HEO's contact information and update if necessary, and review their government's designated BAS contact and update if necessary. The Census Bureau requests that participants complete and submit the annual response form even if their government does not have boundary changes to report. If participants do not respond, the Census Bureau will contact their government to confirm their boundary status. Responding with no changes reduces additional outreach from the Census Bureau. If there are no boundary changes to report, check the appropriate box and return it to the Census Bureau. No further action is required. Every January, the designated BAS contact will receive an email with a link to access the How to Get Started section of the BAS website. To locate the annual response form, scroll to step 2 of the How to Participate section and select Respond Now. The participant should first enter their government's BAS ID or enter their government's name in the Entity Name section. If a participant does not know their BAS ID, they can find it in the subject line of the annual response email. On the form, they should check the first box if their government does not have boundary changes to report. Even if there are no boundary changes to report, it is important to communicate this information to the Census Bureau, as this is still valuable information. If their government does have changes to report, they should leave the box unmarked and move on to the second section below. Participants who have changes to report should then indicate how they wish to receive program materials. There are three options available to participants. They can download digital materials from the BAS website, request digital materials on a disk by mail, or request paper materials by mail. Regardless of the material delivery method indicated on the annual response form, participants can download maps, partnership shapefiles, and GUPS directly from the BAS website at any time. After selecting the appropriate response, the participant should move to Section 2 to confirm that the TC or HEO information is correct, then move to Section 3 to confirm the BAS contact information is correct. The participant should submit the annual response form using the Submit button at the bottom of the online form. After submitting the annual response form, the participant should receive a confirmation email. If there are no changes to report to BAS, there are no further actions to complete. If there are changes to report, the participant should review the appropriate respondent guide for the response method they have chosen to use to prepare and return the BAS submission. Participants can find the BAS respondent guides in the response methods section below the annual response form link. For information on completing a BAS submission using GIS software and the BAS Partnership Toolbox, please view the BAS Partnership Toolbox video series. For information on completing a BAS submission using GUPS, please view the Geographic Update Partnership Software or GUPS video series. Tribal governments should view the Introduction to Tribal BAS series. After participants review the Census Bureau's existing boundary data and complete the annual response form, the third step to participating in BAS is to submit boundary changes using one of the available response methods. The first option to submit boundary changes is to use the Geographic Update Partnership Software, or GUPS. GUPS is an open-source QGIS-based software that contains all the functionality participants need to create their BAS submission. GUPS is intended for those with a basic understanding of or limited experience with GIS software, but is great for participants of all skill levels. The software is available either on a disk or by download from the BAS website. For BAS participants with more experience, the Census Bureau offers the option to use their own GIS software. The Census Bureau provides the BAS Partnership Toolbox and Partnership Shapefiles that participants may download and use to submit boundary changes. While the Partnership Shapefiles are available either on a disk or by download from the BAS website, the BAS Partnership Toolbox is only available by download. For participants with no GIS experience, or who prefer not to submit boundary changes digitally, the Census Bureau offers a paper method for submitting updates. Participants who opt to use this method will receive paper maps in the mail and should make updates directly onto the maps using the provided annotation materials. For additional information and for BAS support, please contact the Census Bureau by phone toll-free at 1-800-972-5651 or by email at geo.bas@census.gov. Participants may also refer to the BAS website for resources.